Hey, what's going on, guys? It's OGCP Da Silva, and welcome back to some Call of Duty Ghosts. No, this is not a fake video. I decided the other day, since I was so burnt out on Advanced Warfare, I would try something a little different. So I threw this disc into my Xbox and just wanted to see exactly what happened. And honestly, I was quite surprised because out of the two games that I played that day, I was able to get both good gameplays. And in this one, I was able to go 32-6. Now, that does not happen in Advanced Warfare for me. And honestly, I can say there is one advantage that Ghost has that Advanced Warfare doesn't. And that's the lack of skill-based matchmaking. That skill-based matchmaking has really screwed over Advanced Warfare a lot. You know, one thing Advanced Warfare or Sledgehammer that I don't understand is why do you have skill-based matchmaking in that game, in pubs? More specifically, when you have a ranked playlist separate, that should have skill-based matchmaking in it. Now, it doesn't make any sense for you to have it in public lobbies, public matches, where the casuals can go, where everybody can just go and have fun. I don't know. I still don't understand that one. You know, I can't wrap my head around that one. You try explaining that one to me. But again, that's none of my business. Let's go ahead and talk about the developers and these gaming companies that are creating these Call of Duty games recently and how they can improve, you know, because as a franchise, we know that it's dying. That topic has been thrown around so many times, it's crazy. But let's talk about how they can improve upon that. And instead of continuing this trend of throwing it down into this downward spiral, let's try explaining to them how they could bring the franchise back up. You know, it's obviously not gonna go back to its once former glory, but how can we continue this trend, or actually discontinue the trend of it going downward and bring it upward slightly? Now, first of all, let's make it very, very simple. Let's go really basic. Go back to your roots. Look back at what the successful Call of Duties did. Look at what was so well done in those games, where your pre-order sales were up, your sales in general were up, there were more hours being spent in those games. Why? Why was that? Was it because of the perks, attachments, maps, movements of the players? What was it? Look at all of those things. Look at where Call of Duty succeeded. And then only will you find out what you're seeking. Also, another thing, and I think this plays a huge role into the success of a product, is if you get consumer feedback. The people actually playing your games, if you get feedback from them, you see what are the legitimate complaints, then improve upon those, learn from your mistakes from previous Call of Duties that didn't do so well, you're able to have a more fulfilling and more rewardful feedback, right? More rewardful, not only product, consumers are happy, you're getting more sales, you're getting that positive feedback, right? That's what you want. As a business, I understand that sales are down. You want to increase those. How are you going to do that? By making a better product. You're not going to be able to do that if you're ignoring what your consumers are saying. It's really that simple. You know? Look at what past mistakes were made, what you guys are doing right now that people are disliking about the franchise. What are you guys doing wrong? First off, let's start with Advanced Warfare and skill-based matchmaking. Even though they choose to ignore it, it is a huge problem in the game. And a lot of times, when they continue to do that, others speak either on YouTube or with their friends in real life. They're talking about, oh hey, don't go out and buy this game because, you know, it's going to be really difficult. You know, this is the worst Call of Duty because the weapons are terrible, the maps are terrible, the guns, etc, etc. You know, we could handpick some of our, you know, most disliked things in the game, but I don't want to do that. You guys have heard enough from different people exactly what those are, but if we pay attention to those as developers and companies making these Call of Duty games, then you're going to be able to determine what works, what doesn't work. And if you take that feedback and improve upon it, you're in turn going to have a better product. You're going to see increase in sales, your pre-order sales. And ultimately, there are two things that you, as the Call of Duty producers, want to hear and see. Number one, sales. You want people to buy your games. You want to set those record-setting numbers. And number two, you want people to talk about your product. If you're putting that much time and effort and working hard to create a game or product, you want the consumers to be happy and you want them to talk positively about what you're producing, right? So at the end of the day, you're able to say, you know what, that was well worth it. But anyways, as my viewers, let me know what they can do to improve the product, what you want to see from the next Call of Duty game. And with that being said, I'll catch you guys next time. This is OGCP Da Silva, and I am signing off.